I've felt a life with where I could not find joy in it. And then I have felt such the polar opposite, skiing down a run.
That's why we all love the sport, is it's a flow state and you gotta be present and you can't think of all these other things.
You know, I think about grief, I think about skiing. I think about skiing as something of a vice. Of it's something that we did as a family. And it's this like piece of continuity that when everything else is going wrong, skiing is something that I feel like we resorted to.
The cotton clouds are dripping down like water mixed with ink to present a gradient from lavender to pink. No golden hours good, flooding all the land with light, but I much prefer the light.
We had a really strong family identity as five skiers. Everything about our life in New Jersey was centered around spending time away from New Jersey. Every move made by our parents was with that priority in mind.
So we built this log cabin and planned it the way we wanted, tweaked it the way we wanted. It was like our little country club, you know, going to Hunto Mountain. We knew everybody. Kids became regulars, went to ski school. You know, Steve in his own way, you know, wanted to live life without boundaries and without conformity. And he never really had a fear of standing out, being, you know, weird. When he laughed, no matter where he was. And he also liked to goof on people.
Oh, that's my boy.
Now, Stevie.
The outdoor space allowed him to make some, you know, risk-reward decisions on a dime, but also see the long game, the big picture of, you know, this is all good. I think he always thought that he did all, you know, he jumped out of planes, he went mountain biking, he skied at a tremendous speed, that something was gonna happen to him.
You know, on Monday, it was a normal nuclear upper middle class family. And on Tuesday, like the world crumbled in.
This just in, you are looking at obviously a very disturbing live shot there. That is the World Trade Center. And we have unconfirmed reports this morning that a plane has crashed into one of the towers.
We don't know anything more than that. We don't know if it was a commercial aircraft. We don't know if it was a private aircraft. We have no idea how many were on board or what the extent of the injuries are right now.
I lost a dad that day. And like the rest of the world watched it happen on television.
You're like, my dad's death is this historical event that's part that changed society, changed history.
On September 11, 2001, an inconceivable terrorist attack would take our Stevie's life.
It's an event that everyone else experienced, and it doesn't feel like there's a lot of room to process it as a personal loss. While everyone around you is also staking a claim to grieving.
Leading up to the 20th anniversary and having to actually go to New York, I think just loaded a lot more anxiety on me than I thought it would. Obviously, going to where my dad died is hard. The 20th anniversary is like a big anniversary, so that makes it even harder. You walk around that memorial, it's still Wall Street. Like, you see businessmen that, like, that could have been my dad. But like they got to go home to their families after. But it's all very important, and I feel so much closer to him when I go there. I think it's weird being in New York because I'm about to go be with a bunch of people who have a shared experience with me and something that I felt pretty alone in my entire life. Sometimes people put this pressure on me and tell me that I'm so strong when I need to know it's okay to be weak today and just cry. Because it's good to feel these emotions, even though I wish I didn't have to.
The more I kept feeling that, you know, my connection to that plate, that area was Steve and also this tragic event. You know, if there was a way to start over or, you know, allow a dream of ours that we had had to, you know, come alive. I thought, you know, maybe that's something that we could pull up our bootstraps and dig up the courage to do.
My junior year of high school, I felt like I was learning the gravity of 9/11 and how much of an impact it had on the world. Growing up in a Japanese American household, especially as a female, like you're put up on this pedestal to check all of these boxes and present as a perfect human, all while I'm grieving my dad's death and trying to understand it more. And I felt just so alone in that experience because we didn't talk about it because we're not an emotional household. And that's just part of Asian culture. And I just got into this really, really negative headspace. And I just kept making mistakes and kept being told by my family that I wasn't good enough. Whether they said that explicitly or not, that's just how I internalized it. And I got to a point, kind of a breaking point, of just feeling like I was never gonna be good enough for my family. And I became so depressed with that thought. I feel so fucked up, and people expect me to be fucked up, so like just let me ride that out. And that whole next few months, I just like thought about dying every day, because that's when you're depressed, like the only thing you can think about is how totally depressed you are. And it's so hard to find joy and get out of that headspace. I think being able to get outside was the only time where I could forget about how terrible my mind, the places it was going. Nature was my saving grace. And I just like got to spend time alone with my thoughts and process everything that had happened to me in my life. And like, it felt like it would take the weight off of my shoulders. And it's also a place where I could like go talk to my dad and just like be okay with who I was. When I was so depressed, I obviously lost confidence in myself and lost faith in myself. And knowing that I could go skiing that day and feel that power is like how I found my way back to myself. When I like click into my skis, that's like what my dad taught me to do. And the fact that I like feel the most confident when I'm skiing makes me, I think that's like what my dad probably would have wanted. I think being able to like find my power through the thing that he showed me and the thing that he taught me is so special.
Skiing, like among other things, has helped me to see like, yeah, dad was killed and thousands of people were killed on this one day for whatever reason. Horrible, but that's not all that the world has to offer.
Part all of our lifestyle decisions would be something he'd probably even be jealous of, maybe, but like looking down and being proud, like all of our lives are in the mountains, you know, and finding happiness there. And happiness, right? Like that's hard to get, especially after something like this.
Even though he's not here to experience that with me, it's like that level of freedom and joy and like confidence is so important. And like that's a life lesson to take away from like how much loss and grief I've experienced, because I just get to like escape that and like feel like I'm truly alive and not, I'm not controlled by the grief and not defined by this like horrible day.
Go to the mountains alone by plane to get home. Throw out my phone, tell everyone I'm gone. I'll be back in a moment. Remember that, keep track. Cause I got a soul that could eat yours whole. I got money in my pocket, pockets are sewn. I got a whole lot of something, nothing is right. So pull up a chair. Stay the night. Stay the